Now, 50 to 1 weren't no fair fight, but 1 plus Bill made it just about right. Well, it was the beginning of a beautiful friendship. From that time on, them two stuck together, like warts on a toad, like birds of a feather. When Bill growed up, it was natural, of course. He'd choose a career to suit him and his horse.
Yep, Bill become a rootin', tootin' cowboy.
Bill was quite a cowboy down in Texas, and the Western Superman, to say the least.
He was the roughest, toughest critter, never known to be a quitter, 'cause he never had no fear of man or beast. So yippee-yi-yay, yippee-yi-yo, for the toughest critter west of the Alamo.
Once he roped the raging cyclone out of nowhere, then he straddled it and settled down with ease. And while that cyclone bucked and flitted, Pecos rolled the smoke and lit it, and he tamed that ornery wind down to a breeze.
So yippee-yi-yay, yippee-yi-yo,
once there was a drought that spread all over Texas, so to sunny California he did go. And though the gag is kinda corny, he brought rain from California. That's the way we got the Gulf of Mexico.
So yippee-yi-yay, yippee-yi-yo, for the toughest critter west of the Alamo.
Mm-hmm.
Once a band of rustlers stole a herd of cattle, but they didn't know the herd they stole was Bill's. And when he caught them crooked villains, Pecos knocked out all their fillings. That's the reason why there's gold in them bar hills.
So yippee-yi-yay,
aye,
yippee-yi-yo,
aye-o,
for the toughest critter west of the Alamo.
Oh, Pecos lost his way while traveling on the desert
water.
It was 90 miles across the burning sand
water.
He knew he'd never reach the border
water
if he didn't get some water,
water.
He got a stick and dug the Rio Grande.
Adiola, oh, oh, yeah.
While a tribe of painted Indians did a war dance, Pecos started shooting up their little game. He gave them redskins such a shake-up that they jumped out from their makeup. That's the way the painted desert got its name. So yippee-yi-yay-yi-yo, for the toughest critter west of the Alamo. While reclining on a cloud high over Texas, with his gun he made the stars evaporate. Then Pecos saw the stars declining, so he left one brightly shining as the emblem of the Lone Star Texas state.
So